Technology guys. All right. So, hi everyone. So, last talk for the day, I think, right? I mean, from the before the coffee break, all right. So, my talk is about next generation notifications. If you're not using Plasma LTS, then you probably got a new next generation notification center, and this talk is basically about three of those three topics. Basically what it can do, what you as application developers should be doing now, new APIs and things like that that you should consider using now, and also an outlook for new features and upcoming versions and new APIs and plans and things and everything. So start up with the feature rundown. I have to increase my notes. Zooming in, just a second. So those are the new features that we have. There's now a new, it's unified notifications and job reporting. We used to have that before, but nowadays the jobs, like if you copy a file, it basically behaves as if you had a notifications. It's shown in the same exact style as any notification. And also there's a new do not disturb mode, which is a common thing these days that you can say, okay, I don't want any notifications. I have to focus on something, on study or doing a presentation or whatever. I don't want to be interrupted in any way. So that's also new in Plasma 5.16. The history got improved and revamped. It's now grouped by application. And other than that, we have interactive previews. If you take a screenshot, for instance, and also because it's a KDE thing, it's very highly configurable, of course. So this beautiful ASCII art, I'm not sure if you can actually see it, but that's actually copied from the source code. It has all the information you need about how it all hangs together. It's basically a string of models which are stacked on top of each other. So you have these tons of models that are then grouped and like stacked together to get the information on screen. So we have these two notification model and jobs model, which are two completely separate things. There's notification server and the job KUI server, which does all of the debug stuff, and then it's merged together using the good named K concatenate rose proxy model. And that's also a thing about there's a framework. So K item models is something you should be checking out if you do any model stuff. The K concatenate rose proxy model, for instance, is in there. And actually got upstream to Qt recently. It's now called Q concatenate tables proxy model. It's in Qt 5.13 because it cannot just concatenate rows but entire table models. It just puts them like one after the other. And then you have all of these models filtering and sorting and grouping and flattening it back down with K descendants proxy model, which is also in K item models. So K item models, if you're doing model stuff, it's amazing. And then at the bottom, there's you seeing your notifications and being annoyed by all of these people that want things from you. So those are some screenshots. That's the interactive preview I was talking about right there in the top left. If you take a screenshot, it's one of my favorite Plasma productivity features. If you take a screenshot, like press Meta Shift Print Screen, you can do a rectangular selection. Then you get a screenshot in your notification, and you can then drag this notification off to your web browser, to your email client, to your chat app or whatever. So like you have this ticket you're writing or Jira or whatever, you have to describe to your client what your problem is. You can just take a screenshot, drop it into your editor, done. So very, very productivity. And then also do not disturb. You can choose for 1 hour. There's also an option for 4 hours now. I added after I took the screenshot. And it's not configurable right now. It's just, it assumes you work from 6 in the morning till 8 p.m. So you can't actually configure yet what times it actually sets us as morning and evening. But yeah, you can't configure all of the things except the weird ones. So, and then there's the download stuff with Plasma Browse Integration, for instance. You also get this progress dialog. And then settings module also got completely revamped. It gives you these general notification settings about do not disturb and about your history and everything. But the new thing is it can also configure non-KDE applications. So it reads the GNOME user's notification hint. So actually your Nautilus and whatever, it actually lists in the KCM right away. And it also remembers all applications that actually send a notification. So once you got a notification from, say, Firefox, it shows up in the list, and then you can just shut it off and tell it not to show notifications. So, for developers, first of all, very important, make sure your desktop file name is set correctly, because otherwise it cannot identify your application, and then it won't allow you to remain in history, because with the history, if you have an application which annoys you in your history and it didn't identify to us, you cannot configure it. So only applications with a proper desktop file name may show up in history. And new in 5.16, you know this notify RC file from Knotifications, which lists all the events. You should now add the desktop entry to it, because Knotifications was done before we were using like these desktop file names for identifying stuff. So it uses the application binary name or something. And so in order to be able to relate it back to an application, you have to add the desktop entry. And if you're not using Knotification for whatever reason and using libnotify instead, there's also this weird C command you can use to set the hint. There's also new an urgency. You can set what kind of urgency notification has, but do so carefully. So in doubt, just leave it on normal. But there's also high and critical and low. So low is like your track change notification in Amarok or whatever. It won't show in history. It is just a one-shot notification that then goes away. And then critical stuff is things like your battery is running out, and those actually show on top of full screen windows. They show in do not disturb mode. So they are so critical, they show up every time, so don't abuse this. You can also set it in the notify RC file, and there's also a libnotify call. So urgency is also a new feature. And then also use default actions. Default action is basically an invisible button on a notification. It makes the entire pop-up clickable. So if you have a chat message, set a default action that clicking the actual pop-up brings up the chat window rather than the user having to hit a button. So default actions. And also prefer setting icon names over pixmaps. So don't do like Q icon from theme and then dot pixmap. Just pass the name of the icon, because then Plasma can load the appropriate colored SVG in case of dark mode and things like that. And then also this URL thing. If you want a nice preview, consider setting URLs. It's originally, I made it so it's a list of URLs. It could be a strip of icons, but effectively only the screenshot application used it, so in the new system actually just looks at the first image, and that's basically it. And it's a custom hint XKD URLs. And actually I've seen other applications like Flameshot, it's also a screenshot application, they also use it, so very nice. I really like when people actually integrate with our stuff, because normally it's us that try to work with everyone, so that's also pretty cool. And then also new, I added it for KDE Connect, basically. It's a way so you can say an origin of a notification. If you get, say, your notification synced from your phone, it can then say, okay, this notification comes from my phone, and then actually show the name of the application on the phone rather than just say KDE Connect. And then also, that's something I would love to see in, for example, Kmail, that it actually uses that and then say, okay, this new inbox notification comes actually from KDE inbox folder or whatever, like show the account name on top of notification, and then it also doesn't group them together. And I actually made a Chromium patch a couple of weeks ago to also show the website name in the title with the origin name. And to my surprise, they were really open to the idea, and they were basically just not looking at the patch for 2 weeks, and then I pinged them again, and they were like, oh yeah, that's a great idea, ship it, basically. So hopefully it's going to be merged in, I don't know, a couple of weeks. So Outlook or Entourage, there's in 5.17, there's a new feature which I think David Ford will love. When you mirror your screens, it will enable Do Not Disturb mode automatically, because normally if you give a presentation like this, you have my laptop screen in front of me and then the presentation on the external monitor, so my notifications would show up like on my screen and you wouldn't see them. But if you're doing like a live coding session or some consulting or Qt Creator demos or whatever, you probably use screen mirroring. And now you can actually have it automatically engage Do Not Disturb mode. So as soon as you mirror your screens, turns on Do Not Disturb mode, no notifications, and nobody can see your naughty little messages. And then Quick Reply is also a new feature I've been working on, that you get a text field in the notification, and then you can just reply to your chat notification right away. But there's some issues with focus, because notification windows never get focus, and that's something I need to discuss with the Quinn people. But that's also something I would love to have in the future. And then I went all crazy. You know, this is Plasma Browser Integration's banner. So what if you have with Plasma Browser Integration, you know, you get integration with Plasma and your Firefox and whatever. So what if you have an app on your phone, normally you have an app on your phone and maybe a desktop website on your computer. What if we go all crazy and then have KD Connect ask Plasma Browser Integration whether your Telegram website is open on your computer and then not sync the notification from your phone because it assumes your website in your browser already showed the notification. So yeah, that's some things I want to plan. And so if you want to get involved in notifications, there's above Tuesday morning, so don't drink too much on Monday evening. And then we can make something amazing happen in the future. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Kai. Anybody has any questions?
Hello. Have you been working on the push notifications for the Android in any library or trying to implement something for it? Because when I was trying to implement push notification with Qt framework, but there was no such support or kind of library I could find to implement it.
What do you mean by push notifications?
Like the any notification that not the local that you get from the like WhatsApp notification or something like that, but okay. For the Qt applications on Android.
No, I haven't done anything like that. Because okay. With our privacy and stuff, you know, we'd rather have an application running which then queries the server rather than being able to push things to the computer. So.
Thank you.
Which one?
So there's this library called, I think it's called Qt Cloud Messaging. If somebody has computer open, you can check. But there's some embedded push notification integration for Caltio, and then there is, I believe, Android support, some Firebase stuff. But this is clearly an area that Qt sucks and should be redone. But for the while being, that might help you forward. But
any more questions? Okay. Thank you.
All right. Thank you.